What is up, everybody? How's it going? Welcome, welcome, welcome. You know what today is? Today is a special day. Well, not a special day, but today is the start of a special month of September. We're on the sixth day, if I'm not mistaken, September 6th of 2023. And we are celebrating Phantom Breaker Festival. Yes, yes, yes. From now until the end of the month, we are celebrating anything Phantom Breaker, whatever we can get our hands on. I'm doing my best to get the arcade version of another code. Is basically the Phantom Breaker arcade version. Phantom Breaker, I want to say it's a mix of, hey, how's it going, random gamer dude, how's it going? It'll be, I think it's a mix of, I think Phantom Breaker Extra, if I'm not mistaken. I gotta double check, but I don't want to give you guys any misinformation, so let me give a double check and I'll get back on that. So we're gonna play a little bit of Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds Overdrive. This one is also available on Nintendo Switch, but the thing with the Nintendo Switch version is it doesn't have online, but it gives you Karisu and I forgot the other character's name. We'll check the name out. And Fau, if I'm not mistaken. Sadly, I do not have Karisu or her, but I do have the game on the Nintendo Switch, so we'll probably do another Let's Play Phantom Breaker Overdrive on the Nintendo Switch, and I'll probably play with Karisu. We'll play the whole game with Karisu. But yeah, before I get started, again, this is Phantom Breaker Festival. It is starting from now until the end of the month. Overdrive isn't on PC, but you can still get Karisu and Faro. It's just called Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds. I do have this on PC as well. I just don't play it anymore. And for some reason, the PC version doesn't remarket six. But anyway, let me get back to what I was saying. So again, Phantom Breaker Festival. The reason why I'm doing Phantom Breaker Festival, in case anyone's wondering, I do a lot for the Phantom Breaker community, online and some offline, with the help of other tournament organizers like Blue. He's a big help, especially like for Evo, and he also helped out in Vortex Gallery. So I'm big round of applause for him and his dedication to the community. Much respect to him. If he does see this, thank you from the bottom of my heart for your contribution to the Phantom Breaker community. And again, much respect to you, and I hope all is well on your end. Another person too that helps out with the Phantom Breaker community is KRX. When I joined the server, I was just a regular member, and I talked to KRX. KRX was the first person to speak with me because I wanted to do tournaments for this game. I was very passionate for this game. And I told him, hey, you know, I'm here to do tournaments. I want to know the community. I want to do what I can for this community. And, you know, a lot of people were a little skeptical because, you know, people come and go from what I've heard. And I'm not like that. When I stick to a game, I like it. I'm not going to go into details because I do have a podcast after this stream explaining more about my involvement into the Phantom Breaker community. But just to give you a little taste. Also, shout outs to Sonderick. He's up right now, but they're over there playing Idle Showdown and Guilty Gear and the Japanese server. But again, I'm letting them be. Thanks to him and the Japanese community for opening their arms as well. And shout outs to him for what he does for his community in Japan and open doors for us to come in and play with them. Again, I'll explain more about the USA and Japan. And also there's another community too, the Brazilian community. They also play Phantom Breaker as well. We'll speak about them later on after this tournament. I want to give a shout out to Rocket Panda Games for one, supporting the tournaments that I do, supporting the community with the prizes. As of last year, Evo, they dropped down $500. Let me snooze this real quick so you don't get hit with the ads. Also CEO Taku, which I came fourth place in. And then this year again with Evo, shout out to MCM for winning that one. They provided $500 as well, and we will hopefully get a prize support by Rocket Panda Games. I do need to hit them up. I know a few of them are busy, so that's why it's kind of like a delay. I want to write them when they come back from what they're doing, because I know a lot of them are busy with events and stuff like that. So once they are back in their homes and stuff like that, the headquarters, then I'll shoot them a message and talk about how we're gonna situate the prize, because it's $500. It's gonna be $500 hopefully, but I'm doing multiple tournaments, so I gotta split that $500 within different games. So tournaments, we do have one coming on the 16th. We have one for Steam for the North America community, and then we have a Japanese tournament, both on the same day. Japanese is going to be early in the morning because it's East Coast time, it's nighttime for them, but East Coast early in the morning, like 8 a.m. we're going to have Steam Japan tournament. And then later on, and I'm pulling the double, later on around 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, we will have the North American tournament. Then I'll have my announcements for the Nintendo Switch tournament, and we should probably have a global tournament as well for Steam, and maybe if there's demands, we'll have a PS4 tournament. Maybe we'll speak about that in the future, but for right now there is a Nintendo Switch, because I've been declining Switch a little bit, because the Nintendo Switch doesn't have what the PS5, PS4, Xbox, and Steam have, PC. We use the Spectate, we use on PC Discord, so you can just share your screen. On PlayStation, you go here, you make a party, and then you share a screen. I'm not going to go all the way at the PlayStation, but if you have a PS5, you make a party, you invite everyone in there, and then you have them share a screen, and you can see the screen from there. And of course, you have a capture card, it's even better. So you could do it like the Xbox. They have to stream, and then you as the host, me, I have a capture card, I can go and, view the matches through OBS, through the internet and stuff like that. But anyway, let's get into Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds. Again, thank you Rocket Panda Games for providing me with this game code. Appreciate you guys. Same thing with Phantom Breaker Omnia. Thank you guys for that. So, if the audio is a little too loud, please let me know. Or to make sure that everything's perfect. Also, shout out to KRX. He designed the overlays for this and the logo for Phantom Breaker Festival. So I did do a playthrough before with Makoto, but out of Makoto, we do have some other characters here. Gonna play a local game. If anyone does have this game, please let me know. We can try out co-op mode. We can play co-op mode. So I already beat the game with Makoto, got her to 50. But we have Waka, we have Isuki, Yuzuha is funny. Yuzuha's my main. Game audio is a little too much. Alright, that should be good. That should be good there. That should be good there. So we got Yuzuha. We have M. You unlock M once you beat the game. Of course, Kokoa. Infinity. He is the last leader of this game. We have Nagi. We have Makoto White or Shiro Makoto. And we have L. And of course, the two DLC characters as well. So if there's any character you want me to pick besides the Makoto, since I got her to 50, we're going to do our best and play the whole game. The whole game. So if there's a character that you want me to play, I will use them for this playthrough. So again, you have your choice from Waka, Isuki, Yuzuha, M, Kokoa, Infinity, Nagi, Shiro Makoto, and L. Let me know. If not, I will pick a character at random. Alright, just a heads up, there's going to be an ad that's going to start in 9 minutes, so let's get this going. So if you're not subscribed to this channel, there will be an ad break. Random? Alright. Alright. Alright, let me do this fast. Alright, we landed on Infinity. Let's see what color he has. We're gonna go with the Dante colors. We're not doing nightmare mode. We'll start off on easy. Alright. So I am using the arcade stick. Also, the tournaments are free to enter, so you're more than welcome to play. If you don't have this game on Steam, I know that our friends from the ARC, Sith Warrior, he will be for the people that don't play. He will have a Parsec up, so you can at least, you know, if you have a PC that can run Parsec, you can still play. Just gotta play through Parsec. So yeah, Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds came out in the 360, Xbox 360, came on Xbox 360 and PC, if I'm not mistaken, and those are the only two ways to play it, because Phantom Breaker was coming out on to America on Xbox, but never did. So it was a Japanese exclusive, but Battlegrounds came to America, and then later on, It made its way onto the PS4, Nintendo Switch. Yes, there is a verse mode, but online isn't the best. So you have to use Parsec. I know I haven't tried the PS4, but I heard that the PS4 is very laggy for verse mode, but not bad for co-op. So another thing too, these characters like Infinity, Kokoa, ML, I believe they don't have like character dialogue like Makoto, Yuzuha, and them have. So it's me playing as the character and beating them up. Oh, we didn't destroy that. That would have gave us a lot of coins. But yeah, just a heads up, there will be an ad in 5 minutes. You can still see the stream, but you will not hear me talk. You will be seeing the ad. Sometimes, the ad will show in the background, and you can still see the stream. But I know, when EVO was going on, I got a lot of ads, so I can still see what was going on. But yeah, I hope we get to play you, random gamer. And we'll do our best to teach you everything that we know. I do recommend when you have a day or two to play with the Japanese community. They're more advanced in this game. Well, not Battlegrounds, but kind of bigger on you. Gotcha. If Sith Warrior does play Phantom Breaker, and he's doing it on Discord, I'll send you a link to his server. That way you can join in on the festivities and try to game out. Again, he uses Parsec with his community, because not a lot of people have this game on Steam for on his community, so. And also gives people a chance to try it out if they're skeptical. But his community is very humble. Like, Phantom Breaker isn't their game, but they support their community members, because they mainly play Sonic the Hedgehog games. But they're supportive with like the other people that like to play fighting games and stuff, so they'll join in, even though like they have no idea what's going on, so. But the Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds and Phantom Breaker Amiya, they share the same button format. They share the same button form now. So basically, I'm gonna lose all my power because I'm overhyped here. So now I lose all my power and I have to level up. So then I use this XP. I can. It has like a little bit of RPG element, so I can either boost my attacks or get some skill points like double jump. Dash attack, special attack, combo. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna do that for now and then. And that's it. That's all I can do for right now. So again, he doesn't have dialogue because, again, I'm playing as a boss character. Now I'm just slow. I'm using my arcade stick on this. So, since this is a beat-em-up, right? And you're moving left and right, usually this is this attack here that I'm doing right there. It's back special, but for this game you have to dash and then hit special. And collecting money too, collecting these orbs, they help you level up. Infinity's pretty fun character to use in Phantom Breaker Amiya. But very difficult to master. Hopefully some of the other people stop on by. I know a few people that have this game, but they haven't opened it. They have their sealed copies. I don't have a sealed copy, I just have the digital copy. So what's cool about this is this beat-em-up doesn't really have a sequel, but the creators of this beat-em-up franchise did make another game, and it's just like this. I forgot the name of it, but it's on PC. Maybe I'll check it out and get it and play it on stream. Not right now, but some other time when I do like my beat 'em up segment. So in Phantom Breaker Overdrive, you have these like see what I'm doing here? That's like Amiya attack. We can also change the elements later on to fire and rock. Give me a second. I feel like something's going on. If you're typing in the chat, I cannot, for some reason, it's not showing it. Like, it shows that something's going on, but then it doesn't show if you're writing. Let me see something. Alright. I don't know. I thought my OBS was acting up. So Infinity's a little tricky in this game. And another thing that sucks too is, like, I don't have my superpowers. These guys remind me of the little, like, elves in Golden Axe that have, like, the food and points and all that. They drop potions. I don't know if you remember Golden Axe. How did I get this again? How did I pick that up? Hold on. Controls. That's not good. All right, hold on. I already have an attack plus. Okay. I'm not coming yet. If you have any questions, let me know, man. I can answer them. Even if it's about Phantom Breaker or Omnia. If you need any, like, character advice and stuff like that, I can I can show you as well. You can play a little bit of this. I can show you some characters if you're interested in. Give you an idea of what to do. And then I can come back and play this. And then there's like animation moves that like I wish they would like had added an Amiya. Like I like the Gashwin animation in this game. I like it a lot. But it's exclusive to this game. Red Mikoto. Even the Shoryuken is... Even the Shoryukens, though. There we go, stage one complete, well, stage two complete. We're leveling up fast. Air dash. All right, so we have decent stats. We're in stage two now. So So we still have that attack plus. But yeah, if you have an arcade stick and you have and you get this game, I recommend playing on stick. It just gives you that whole beat 'em up vibe. Like if you're playing it at the arcades. Get all those rubies, all those coins. You want to get all those points. That's what's going to help you. It's going to help you level up. It'd be cool if they make like another beat-em-up of this game, but not sure what Rocket Panda Games has in store for us. I'll tell you this though, if I ever win the lottery, half of the money, I want to like develop the next Phantom Breaker game. Or like have Arc System. Or act like CY Games. Like, have the old team that made this, but have the animation by CY Games or Arc System. That would be really cool. Rocket Panda Games is making like a JRPG of this game. Oh, I'd be so happy. Fekakoa here. No dialogue. What is that like so much about the series? I'll answer that real quick. 1 second. Let me just beat her real quick. And I'll get to that question. I died. Okay. So. No. I don't like beat 'em. I play fighting games. I'm a fighting game organizer, like you see here. I do like my JRPGs, but no, I play fighting games. I play Melty Blood, Street Fighter 6. I mean, just to name a few. I'm old school. I'm from arcade days, playing Street Fighter 2. I mean, I do enjoy beat 'em ups, my armor cores. Saint Seiya, you know, I grew up with anime as well. Virtual Fighter. So what I like about the franchise. Hit the wrong button. So what I like about the franchise. So the franchise is really cool. It has that old school feel to fighting games, because Phantom Breaker series came out around when I had the 360. So I want to say 2011, 2012. Correct me if I'm wrong. But around that time, that's when I knew about Phantom Breaker. I didn't own the game, but a friend of mine had his Xbox 360. What was it called? JTAG. He had his modded. And how I met my friend was at an anime convention. It was here in Orlando, called AFO, and they had a gaming area, and he had his 360, and they were like, this is where you can meet like Ruben Landon, who he played the voice of Ken Masters in the Street Fighter series, 9 and 6 though, but I think 4 and 5 he played the voice of Ken. But anyway, there was a meet and greet, and you could play him and all that in the tournament. But while we were waiting on him, they had other games, and he had Phantom Break. I was like, oh, what the hell is this? Well, not what the hell is this. I was like, oh, you have this? Like, I've been waiting for this game to come to America. So he had it, but bootleg, because that was like the only way you can get the game if you had a modded 360, because it was coming to America, but for some reason it got lost in the storage and only a few people got it. But I liked the game. At the time when I was playing, like, I was already like in my Street Fighter phase, you know. It was Street Fighter, MK, Guilty Gear. So when I played it, I didn't feel for it much, you know, because again, I didn't own the game, so I didn't have much appreciation for it in the past. Later on, when Extra came out on the PS3, I imported it from Japan. That's when I started to appreciate the game more. So if you want to ask me how when I started playing this game, I started playing this game more when I got my hands on Extra. And I played the game, you know, I'm a fighting game collector. You know, I'm a fighting game collector. But this is a question that was supposed to be for the podcast later. But I'll say this. What got me into the game was, one, the animation, the music. The music's really good for the Phantom Breaker, Extra, and Omnia. The music's really good. It was really, really good music. It's easy. A lot of people that I was looking at on the Discord, they were having issues doing combos and all that. When I first played, yeah, you know, when you start a new game, a new fighting game, yeah, you're gonna have difficulty doing combos, because, you know, if you just jump into the game. I know this game doesn't have combo trials, but again, we have a community that's dedicated. There's some tutorials that a lot of people have done for Phantom Breaker Omnia, and they have character guides. So if you go on Twitter, you can join the Discord. You know, I know the Japanese scene, they do have some footage and lessons on characters and all that. But yeah, the animation was cool. It's unique at the time. I compared it to the animation at the time. I compared it to Guilty Gear and a little bit of Blaze Blue. And also, if I'm not mistaken, I know like you had Marvel Superheroes and X-Men versus, no, not Marvel Superheroes versus Street Fighter, Marvel vs. Capcom. I know they had like easy modern controls, so you could select it, like you could do your buttons. And I want to say Marvel vs. Capcom 2 kind of had modern control. No, not really, but like when you're doing your combos, like it had auto attacks and all that stuff, so I, you know, that thing. But Phantom Breaker, it had modern controls. It was easy. It was easy to do moves and stuff like that. that was another thing too. So it felt like playing Smash Brothers in a way. I don't remember much of extra because like it was long ago, but I know like some of the movesets was like down, like the special button or down special button, you know, with your light attack and with your heavy attack, sorry, with your heavy special and heavy attack, stuff like that. Again, it's been a minute, so I don't want to like give you guys misinformation. But yeah, it's a fun game. Like I said, I don't want to get too much because I do have a segment later after I play a little bit of Battlegrounds. I am gonna talk about Phantom Breaker. You know, I forgot to put music on here. I'll put some music here in a little bit. Background music and put a picture because my webcam's acting up right now. But yeah, that's all I can say for right now about what I like about the game, because I wanna speak about it later. But if you want to talk about beat 'em ups, man, I can talk about beat 'em ups real quick. Beat 'em ups for me, I grew up playing a lot of beat 'em ups in arcades. I'm from New York, North Carolina, and then coming down here. I want to say my first beat 'em up is my first beat 'em up playing, I want to go with Double Dragon. I want to go with Double Dragon, and it was on the NES. But then I played the arcade version. But yeah, console first beat 'em up console was Double Dragon. If I want to go with the arcade, it's a mix between Bad Dudes and Bad Dudes and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And then I fell in love with Final Fight. Final Fight's like one of my favorites, bro. Final Fight is one of my favorite beat 'em ups. Like I played that as a kid growing up, and then later on, you had The Simpsons, you had Battletoads, and then Capcom used to dish out a lot of beat 'em ups. The one with the robots, you could play with Jin's father. I forgot what it was called. And then he had Cadillac and Dinosaurs. Captain Commando was really good. And then SNK had some good ones. Sengoku games, I played them all. Those were fun. Sengoku games were fun, especially like the first one when you could transform into the dog. I used to love that. I used to play all that. Ape Man After. It wasn't a beat 'em up. It was more like a side scroller, but I believe that this was SNK's version of Ghouls and Ghosts. I played a lot of Ghouls and Ghosts too in arcades, and of course on Nintendo and Super Nintendo. But Magician Lord, I don't know if you ever played Magician Lord. Magician Lord was old school from the arcades. That was SNK's Ghosts and Goblins or Ghouls and Ghosts. Oh, yo, real quick, man. If you guys don't know what Magician Lord is, I know it doesn't involve Phantom Breaker, but let me see if I can find Magician Lord real quick. Just so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Let me see if I can find it real quick. Hold up. There's a lot of advertisements, so I'm muting it so I don't get hit with a copyright strike. Alright. Let me see. Let me go here. Okay. Let me go here real quick. Can you hear it? Alright. This is a Magician Lord. Oh, we're in ad break. On. Once the ad break is over, I will play it. Yeah, we gotta wait a minute. We gotta wait a minute. I apologize. I apologize. Also, sorry for the segment. Supposed to be playing Phantom Breaker, not showing off Magician Lord, but again, this is one of my favorite games when I was a kid that I played at the arcades. It's a long minute. So we'll play this for a second. All right, that break is over. So yeah, let me just show you Magician Lord real quick. This is, not at different FC, but you collect orbs, you could become different ca magicians. You got Waterman, Samurai. I always like the Shinobi. Dragon Warrior was pretty cool too. But yeah, this is like the intro. Like the intro of the game. And the music for the first stage was fire too. It's almost. But I'll show you how the game looks and then we'll get back into Phantom Breaker. But this was my game. I used to pump in quarters like crazy. And that's the last leader. The last leader was like. He was like a bioweapon. He looked like a bioweapon. I can also say that this rivals Strider as well. That was another game too that was good. Oh, this is the Sega CD version, so they added extra. They added extra. I mean, that's Sega Neo Geo CD. This wasn't an arcade. Yeah, this is all Neo Geo CD. My bad. All right, here we go. But the music was tight. So this is how Magician's Village is. I don't want to say it's a beat 'em up, but it's a side scroller, I guess. That's what you call these side scrollers. You had magic powers like Contra. But that's how it was. I used to play this like crazy in arcades. If they had it. You can transform. Yeah, you start off with the dragon first. And you can move the head around. Even when you're going down the ladder, you can shoot fire. All right. I don't want to show too much because, again, this doesn't involve Phantom Breaker. But yeah, that's just a little taste of me, of like some of the stuff that I played. But yeah, I grew, and then, you know, of course, fighting games. I played, my first fighting game was actually Karate Champ, and then after that was Internal Champion. Oh no, not Internal Champions, just fucking Sega. That one for Nintendo, Urban Champion. There we go, Urban Champion. That was another fighting game on Nintendo. I like playing that game. And then I played Karate Champ and Street Fighter, but it was Fighting Street when we had it. I think my brother had like a TurboGrafx. Was that TurboGrafx? We almost had like, except for the 3DO and freaking Jaguar, but. We almost had a lot of the consoles from back in the day. So I remember Bonk and all that. We had a Turbo Graphics. As for fighting games, yeah, Street Fighter was like the main game. Street Fighter 2, loved it. Then Mortal Kombat came out. Then we had Fatal Fury, Art of Fighting, one of my favorites as well. King of Fighters, love King of Fighters. Darkstalkers. Then we had X-Men: Children of the Atom came out. That's what brought us Marvel vs. Capcom. Yo, what's up? Enjoy your nap, man. So this right here, these are like bonus stages. You got like a time limit, you gotta break these eggs. And they give you a whole bunch of stuff. I recommend just doing special. I missed out. Yeah. Yeah, he just do his specials. But you know, get a lot. You come back to it later when you're jacked up and you can just beat up on everything. We'll come back to that. Save our points. So we're in stage 3 now. But yeah, man, if there's any characters that you play on Phantom Breaker, or if you want to get into Phantom Breaker, let me know. I can do a demonstration on Omnia characters. We can do that later. Be here overdriving like crazy. If only overdrive combos were more like that in Omnia. Got here in the sewers. I hate these little bastards. If you have a PlayStation and you want to play, I can set up the share play. You just need to add me as a friend, but you need to have PlayStation Plus for it to work. And we can share play. You can play with me if you want. But if you own this game and you want to play online, you can do that as well. Because Phantom Breaker Festival is not just me as a streamer streaming Phantom Breaker games. It's a community thing. This is for the community. We're celebrating the game. Community. We can play games with each other. give me a second, because this is bothering me a little bit. Like that. Have a little white screen. It felt like they were stretched taller. This is perfect. Enough power to break that, but if you break that, you get a lot of coins. That was a waste of an overdrive, or whatever. A lot of XP. I think we're gonna hit like 18 or something soon. We'll do like a Q&A in 30 minutes. We'll do a Q&A. You can ask me questions. If you're still here, you can ask me questions. And for the people that are watching, I do appreciate you guys. We'll do a Q&A and then we'll jump on Omnia. Thank you. I forgot who's the boss here. Yeah, I forgot. I forgot you can throw in this game. Totally forgot you can throw in this game. Oh, Coca-Cola again. Oh yeah, and the dragon. Yo, she's just gonna spam? I got it. She's got the cheese. Yeah, we'll beat this game fast, I think. I know, like, the last level, it's like a maze, and it takes forever, but we're going on, going fast time. We can play an infinity, and I have attack plus. So I'm playing a boss character. Infinity is the last leader for this game. Technically, he's kinda is the last leader in Omnia as well. The real villain is M. I mean, Phantom, sorry. But he's not... He's not a playable character. I'm just killing them left and right. Oh, this stage is funny. I think Phantom pops up here and starts shooting laser beams, if I'm not mistaken. I hate those cake guys who are gonna spam cake. So if you want to say cheese, these are the cheesers. The dynamite! Oh, that's a waste. That was a waste. Yeah, I think that's Phantom, right? He's a look. Yeah, that's Phantom. Yeah, look at him. Phantom, I work for you. Toss the cheesecake. Ooh, that was a nice... I reflected that. That guy air dash. Yeah, he's swole. He's swole in this game. ABC, 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 ABC. There we go. Now we got fire. I think that was a big mistake, but whatever, we'll deal with it. Oh shit, it's Rhyhorn. Mages is about to get sued by Nintendo company. Damn! Damn! I hope you all get sued by Nintendo. Nah, I'm just kidding. The right horn, right on, or whatever the last horn is. Right, Imperior or some shit like that. I need all that. I need all that. Oh, he dropped the donut. Welcome back. If you guys were in that ad, I do apologize. I do try to control the ads on the stream, but again, it's Twitch. Twitch is doing. But if you guys are still here that watch the ads, I do appreciate you guys, because watching ads do help the channel out a lot. So I appreciate you guys. I'm sorry that you had to watch the ads. I know some ads are like 10 minutes. Oh, look at Phantom. Just chilling. Phantom, what are you hitting me for? Oh, burger. I don't know why I can't collect those, but... just weird. Oh yeah, I gotta fight these two at the same time. I never seen them be so spammy like this. Because I'm playing like a boss character? The funny part is, I'm playing on easy. Berserk, yeah, Berserker Barrage. Got her. Oh snap! Her bombs. Oh yeah, yeah, I forgot about this mode. I feel like I'm playing Devil May Cry. Beating the game. Now we unlock super moves. Or EX moves. So now that we got some power in him, oh snap! This is actually a combo in Phantom Breaker Omnia. this light. If he lets me do the damn combo, I'll do it on someone else. God, that guy was annoying. Get some. Alright, let's see what we have here. Wow. You again. I got you. Is that ice? Me fuck with ice. Oh, I like the ice better. There's a light attack in him. Yeah, it's sick of ice. Like, the fire was nice. Let's go. I'm just light attacking everything. Oh shit. Ah. Strongest attack. It's just that you can do this combo in Phantom Breaker Omnia. You can like air juggle. I'll show it to you in a second. There we go, the power of light attack. Break this. Oh yeah, we're near the end, because if I'm gonna fight those girls. Yeah, the ninja girls? Yeah, we're near the end of the game. Those girls are annoying. Got some ice walls out here. Yeah, these throw fire, then I think you got one of those elements. There's different elements. Yeah, these are the ice ones. Damn, these little girls are annoying. I need food. Yeah. Imagine if these girls are the only. Damn. Let's go. He's almost dead. There we go. Yo, I had to put him in the corner, man. That's what this game's trolling, because I think I random selected Infinity. Because I asked earlier who to pick, and someone said random, so I was just going through the joystick real fast. And then whoever I hit X on, that's how I was going to play this whole playthrough. Yeah, we're near the end of the game. I might as well just finish it, and then we can talk. We can do Q&A. Now, I know this part here is going to take a minute because it's a puzzle. So I'm going to try to do my best to finish this part fast. I know I remember this part being a puzzle. So you had to go through, these little orbs and then kill all of them. And then what makes it hard too is that these little suckers are hard to see in this map if they're up on top. Oh my god, I'm just in a freaking fire loop. Did I not kill you? Oh, I thought I killed you. Jeez. This little let's play that I'm doing is I've played the stream before, and it wasn't, this game before, and it wasn't that bad with those girls, but I think it's because I'm playing Infinity. Let's go. I'm good. Oh, I have to break these, huh? Done with break these? Yeah, I think I gotta break these. I had to break those on the exit. Okay. Yeah, this is the part I was telling you about. It's like a... I had air dash. Okay. Red Makoto. All right, Red Makoto is gone. Now we're going to fight Nagi. Cheese. If they do an update to Omnia, I hope they put Nagi in there. Nagi should have been in Omnia. Not like a Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds like exclusive character. Should have been dope. Yeah. This is the last level. Here we go. We did the combo. Okay. Good. We did it. We did it. There we go. Give me a second, I gotta save that. I like this one. I like this one better. Thank you. Alright, we're near the end of the game. This Infinity has a different color. Oh wow. Yo, this game, this match jipped me, man. That jipped me. He dodged right when I was doing my super. That's hilarious. I got this. Oh, come on. I'm blocking everything. I gotta do this shit again. And everything on that side. Again, this I die near the end. Ah, this is annoying. And I accidentally ate the food. That's not good. I accidentally ate the food. I got him. I just gotta block. Block these attacks. It's got time to attack. This last lead just for you. Get out of here. I got this. He's easy. Oh, come on. There we go. I just had to play smart and get the food. Give me 1 second. Okay. This is the ending. I mean, not gonna see infinity. We'll probably play with Nagi next time. Well, that rolls. Let me get an image, because again, my webcam isn't working. So let me just find an image real quick of me on Facebook. So let me real quick. Put some music in the background. And let me get a picture real quick. Sorry, I know it's kind of oof, that's taking up the whole screen. My bad. Let me morph this real quick. That's me, if anyone wants to know. I haven't used my webcam in a while. I've been looking to buy one soon, but that's me, your boy Shinji, your Phantom Breaker Amiya TO community. I want to say, well, not like a community manager, but I'm your guy. I'm the Phantom Breaker guy. That's my nickname. If the music is overpowering my voice, let me know. But right, it's Q&A time, so let me get to Vercon X's question that he asked earlier that I did give some. Did get a little bit of questions, but he asked me what got me into this game. We answered that. But the best question is what got me into fighting games. Well, Growing up, I was born in New York. My family's from Panama, so I'm the only American in my family. But I'm just Panamanian. I don't like to say I'm from the United States, but I've been to Panama like crazy. So it's I got Panama in me. I know my culture. I know my family. I know my country. But yeah, so what got me into fighting games? So growing up, I was born in the 80s. I was born in 85. So I grew up with Voltron. Let me put this music on the loop. So I grew up with Voltron, Gatchaman. I mean, even though Gatchaman was like in the 70s, but reruns and all that. G.I. Joe. I wasn't born when G.I. Joe like first appeared, but when I was born and I had hand-me-downs because of my brothers, it was so, they had the cartoons and all, Transformers, Voltron, all that stuff. Like, I wasn't born when they came out, but when I was born, they were still relevant. They were still showing the cartoons, Thundercats, all that stuff, So I grew up also, like, I used to watch a lot of animes. There was a lot of animes, but to me as a kid, there were cartoons to me. You get what I'm saying? I didn't know there were anime. So going to Panama and watching cartoons in New York and watching cartoons growing up, what got me into fighting games was I want to say my brothers, they had the Nintendo. We always went to the arcades, and like I said, when I witnessed playing Karate Champ, I didn't know it was a fighting game. It's, arcade game. You get what I'm saying? I didn't know it was a fighting game until later on when Street Fighter 2 came out. That's when I heard the term fighting game when I, go to the arcades and stuff like that. So again, what started the fighting game like in me was Street Fighter 2 when I was at the arcades. That's what got me into like the FGC and stuff like that at a young age, because my brothers would always go to the arcades. Especially we would go sometimes in New York, but a lot was in North Carolina. When I lived in North Carolina for a little bit, we would always go to the arcade, and then my sister would work at a Subway, and then right next door was the arcade, so she'll pick me up from school, watch me for a little bit, because my mom was working, so was my dad, and then they'll come and pick me up from the arcade, and I'll just go in there and freaking play Street Fighter. It was Street Fighter 2, then Champion Edition. We also had a skating rink too that had Street Fighter, freaking Champion Edition, Hyper Fighting. And then when it came to the consoles, I got, we had it on Super Nintendo and all that. But I was always at that arcade. Killer Instinct, I played that as well. So I loved fighting games from a young age. And then PlayStation came out, and I didn't own a PlayStation, but I got a Nintendo 64. And my brothers knew me so well. Like, I did enjoy Mario as a kid. I played Sonic. Till this day, I haven't even beat the original Sonic 1 and 2. My brothers did, but I haven't. I don't know, for some reason Sonic, like, I love Sonic the Hedgehog. I had the Sega Genesis. It's just Sonic for me. It wasn't it, but Mario, I played the Marios. I stopped at Mario Sunshine. I didn't play the other Mario games. But when the Nintendo 64 came out, my brother was he enrolled himself in the army, and he managed to get a Nintendo 64 for me for Christmas. And now, this was day one Nintendo 64, so the games were limited. There was like Star Wars, Mario 64, and some other stuff. Wave Race, Pilot Wings, whatever. My brother knew me so well when he got me the Nintendo 64. My first game on console launch was Killer Instinct Gold. He knew I would have more fun playing fighting games than playing Mario 64, and it did. Yo, I was so happy, man. That was like my first console. Like for me, you know, I had hand-me-downs my whole life, like Nintendo, Super Nintendo. So like the N64, it was cool. That was my first like fighting game on a console. Well, that was mine. We had fighting games on Super Nintendo and all that. I had Street Fighter and all that. My brother had a PlayStation, my other brother, and I know when he got his PlayStation, the first two games that he got was one called Warhawk, and then the second one was Battle Arena Toshinden. That was like a fighting game. Yo, I loved that game. My main was Eiji. I love playing as Eiji. So as you know, as I got older, you know, we had more games. I got myself a PlayStation. I had Street Fighter Alpha. That was dope. That's when like Capcom changed their animation. It was more anime because like the Street Fighter anime came out around that time too. So it was more like anime, and I loved it. And I loved the new route that they were doing with Street Fighter Alpha. They kind of used like the what was it, CP2 engine, right? With Darkstalkers. So they kind of used that Darkstalkers animation. We saw the evolution of what the fighting games were going to be when Darkstalkers came out. And then believe it or not, Final Fight was what started the whole shadows when they did the supers. You had the shadows in the back because Rolento, when you fought Rolento in his stage in the elevator, he will move around so fast that he had the shadows going on. So they took that concept and they put it towards Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo Grandmaster Challenge, you know, the Street Fighter 2 that everyone loves. So we had that going on. So if, you know, I don't want to like sit here and give you my whole history. So fast forward to FGC days. So my first, like, I want to say official FGC tournament was when we had EB Games and Babbage's before GameStop, and they did Street Fighter Alpha 3 on PlayStation. That was my first, like, FGC tournament, like, console-wise. Because, like, we had tournaments at the arcades and all that for KOF, Street Fighter 2, and all that. And then, my first console one was Street Fighter Alpha 3. And I didn't do too bad. I didn't win. I forgot what place I got. But I know I beat my first two opponents, and then after that, I lost. So I think I went 2-2. It was pretty cool. Street Fighter Alpha. And then we had the arcades over here. Tilt. We had Marvel vs. Capcom. X-Men vs. Street Fighter. Marvel Super Heroes and all that. So I used to meet up. Like, I used to go to the weekends and go to the arcade at the mall all the time and just play those fighting games. And then, also, of course, I played a lot of DDR, Dance Dance Revolution. I played that a lot, too. So it wasn't just fighting games when I went to the arcade. Also, Initial D. I played a lot of Initial D, Wygon Midnight, you know, so it wasn't just fighting games that I would go in and play. You know, if it was packed, I would play something else. I'll play like a shooter, like House of the Dead. That was one of my favorite shooters. Was House of the Dead. I played that a lot. So my involvement with the FGC as a tournament organizer. So when I moved to Florida, you know, school, all that, after school was over and all that, and Street Fighter 4 came out, that's when I got more into learning how to be a TO. And that's how I met Alex Jabaley, CEO, you know. He lives not too far from me. It's like 30 minutes from my house. But nice dude. I'm not saying that just to say it. He's cool. I know like a lot of people are like, oh, he has an ego and all that. It's just that he gets stressed out when it's his tournament and all that. There's so much shit that goes on in these tournaments. So he's all over the place. You get what I'm saying? And he wants to say what's up. He wants to say hello. He does take the time to say what's up to you. But again, he is focused on his event because he wants to make sure that, one, it's good, everyone's safe, and he wants to make sure that, you know, that that's more important. You get what I'm saying? But yeah, if it wasn't for Alex Jabaley, like, he used to do a lot of locals. He on Will's Pub, that's where I first met him. He would host at the bars. He will host at Gamers Inc., some card shops, comic book places, restaurants. You get what I'm saying? That was the spark of CEO. Like, CEO, it's like I said, it started from just local areas, and then he got his location at the hotels and all that, and then afterwards he built up from the ground up, you know. And I learned a lot from him, but also I learned from other TOs as well, like Alex Valle, Shin Blanca from Atlanta, Big E, you know, L.I. Joe, you know, East Coast Throwdown. So I've been to a few of those events, and also like the locals and all that. So I picked up piece by piece of how to host a tournament, how to be a TO. And let me get you straight, I wasn't perfect. My first tournament went well, but it had a lot of backlash because I didn't have consoles. You get what I'm saying? So that was the thing too. When I started, I was expecting the community to bring their stuff, and in reality, yes, they can bring their stuff, but you were the one that was supposed to provide everything, like the consoles and all that. So I had a lot to learn over the years. You get what I'm saying? Like, community, making friends, you know, like, I'm still decent in fighting games, but I was very competitive back in the day. But now I just like to chill. I still play. I have to play because, like, the stuff that I do is I'm a streamer. Like, I'm a one person thing. I used to have a group before things fell through, and now I'm working my way up with a new brand. I had an old brand, but, you know, I just don't want to get into that. But we're here with Final Wave Esports. That's my my brand, my my esports team. I did have people. I had a Pokemon Unite team. I did have some FGC players. I did have one still, but I don't think he plays DNF Duel anymore. But he's a homie. He's still part of the crew and all that. But what I want to do is I want to get back into that. I want to get back and sponsor in some people. So I did sponsor a few people. I want to get back into that. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But yeah, you know, it's all trial and error. All trial and error. Even with my online tournaments, you know, it wasn't perfect. You know, I started with Street Fighter 5, then when the pandemic happened, that's when I kind of blew up a little bit with Battle for the Grid. So I was doing a lot of Battle for the Grid tournaments and all that. And then after a while, I switched over to different games and, you know, Pokemon Unite. I want to go back into Pokemon Unite, but little by little, that community is like slowly dying. But I still play the game. I just do my thing with Pokemon Unite. But yeah, I learned a lot to be honest. I learned a lot from Alex Jabaley with what I'm doing now. So fast forward to Phantom Breaker, to this game. We're gonna talk about Amiya. I'm not gonna talk about the past. So this game, when I saw the trailer, it was 2019. And I applied to be a tester or reviewer, and Rocket Panda Games, I forgot the name of their other company, they wrote me back and said, hey, we're very interested. You know, they gave me an email. Again, this was like 2009. We didn't even know the pandemic was going to happen. So they're like, yeah, you know, the game's coming out soon. Because, yeah, Phantom Breaker Omnia was going to drop in 2019, 2020. You got what I'm saying? It was going to drop. So I was going to get my hands on it. I was going to do tournaments. I wrote them like, hey, I'm going to, you know, I'm an up-and-coming, well, I don't want to say up-and-coming tournament organizer, because I've been doing this for a while. Well, like, being a TO, I want to say 2012 was when, like, I sparked the TO, being a TO, 2012. But I've been in FGC since, like, the 1990s. But yeah, like, as a TO, I want to say 2012. I'll be 2012, 2011, around there, when CEO happened. When the first CEO happened at the Wyndham, it was 2011. Well, and that was the second CEO. The first CEO was at in Orlando at an airport hangar. But yeah, evolution of CEO right there. But anyway, so I wrote Rocket Panda Games, and I told him like, yo, you know, I'm interested in this. You know, I remember seeing this game. I played the beat 'em up. And I played the original because, you know, like I mentioned before, my friend had it bootlegged off his Xbox. And then I had extra on the PS3 because I imported it. My cousin got it for me, actually. That and what was the other one? Arcana Hearts. He got me that as well. So I told him all that, you know, I'm looking forward to this game. I want to play it. Pandemic happened, and the game didn't come out until what, 2021, 2022? I want to say around there. Let me check. Yeah, it was like 2022. It was around there. I want to believe 2021 and 2022, around there. I think it was, no, 2021. It's 2021, right? Hold on. Let me double check. Because during the pandemic. So Phantom Breaker, the series started in 2011. So yeah. But Phantom Breaker Omnia. Phantom Breaker Omnia was released. Okay, it was released in 2022. All right. But yeah, like to the public. To the public 2022. But it's been. Omnia has been advertised since like 2019. But it was released in 2022. Because again, the pandemic. And then also, they wanted to get American voice actors and all that. But, what I do for the community, right? We're gonna get into that. What I do for the community. So you guys know that if you guys are watching, you're gonna watch it later. You guys know that I do care about this game. I do love this game. I know there's times I get salty and say, yo, I hate this game, but I really don't. I like it. I respect Mages and Rocket Panda Games for what they do for the game. And also, you know, giving me the opportunity to, you know, play the game, test the game out before anyone else. You know, I had the game like 2 weeks before the official release to test out and review and all that, give my thoughts. I do have it on Steam, PS4, and Nintendo Switch. I don't have it on Xbox, but soon I will. I will get an Xbox soon. You know, they're nice enough to provide me copies. I'm not talking bad about other streamers or other FGC content creators, but there are some, I'm not gonna mention their names. There are some that I saw their tweets like, oh, you know, I'm gonna do some tournaments for this game, but when they found out that there was no lobby modes or spectate, this was delayed based games, you know, everyone's like, oh, it has to have rollback and all that. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you guys. It did hurt me. I was like, oh shit, you know, what am I gonna do? There's no rollback. There's no spectators mode. How am I going to make this game work online? And then I was like, wait a second. We've been playing games on delay base for a minute. The reason why we need rollback was when the pandemic happened. We had we had nothing. Like there was no tournaments. We couldn't do anything. So rollback netcode was what we needed, you know, and that's cool. You know, everyone needs that. Everyone needs the rollback netcode, you know, but people need to understand, especially FGC heads that play online. Yo, give me a second. Give me a second. My alarm went on. Give me a second. All right, so I'm back. Sorry about that. So people need to understand that we didn't have rollback back then, and we played Street Fighter 4, we played Blaze Blue, we played Tekken. Shit, people are still playing Dragon Ball Fighters right now, and they haven't had the rollback thing yet. You get what I'm saying? So I don't see why people can't give Phantom Breaker a chance. I mean, we have a sale going on. We have 2 weeks. You can get on Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 4 for what? $4? $4 or $5, if I'm not mistaken. Like, go get it. It's a really good game. I trust you. I mean, trust me. Like, for that price, you're getting a good game. You're getting a good game, and it's helping recommending games out too by purchasing the game. And we have dedicated servers. We have Japanese. We have the main recommended games. We have a tournament server. You know, I'm here for you guys. Like I'm active mostly every day for all three servers, the Japanese, the global, and the recommended games server. I'm not saying I'm the best player in this game, but I'm pretty decent in teaching that you won't like lose, you know. And I play Yuzuha. I mean, I can play any character, but Yuzuha is like my main. But I do dab. I'm dabbling with Shiro Makoto now, because we're gonna do like a secondary tournament. But it's more the Japanese people. I'll try to implement it to NA. But anyway, about Phantom Breaker Omnia, about me. So when I saw like Share Play PlayStation, I was like, all right, this is what we're gonna do. And I actually watched Sanda Rick's tournament. I was like, oh, how's this Japanese guy hosting tournaments? How's he doing his online tournaments? So then I saw that he was doing PlayStation, and he was doing Share Play through PlayStation. I was like, oh shit, I totally forgot about that. And thanks to him, I used that information and I brought it towards NA. So I did that with PS4 and Steam. You know, we have share screens and all that. I knew all about that since back in the day. So I did that with Steam. Steam will all join in the voice call, and then I'll tell you, hey, MCM, hey, KRX, you know, one of you guys share your screen. Whoever has the good internet connection, you know, share the screen. And then, you know, for instance, like, you know, we're demonstration, right? Demonstration. So you just get out of, let's get out of Overdrive. Let's go to Phantom Breaker Omnia. So let me change the title real quick. So for instance, like, we have this, right? And I want to do tournaments, so I'll put my scoreboard here, as you see here. So, actually, this is good to check. So, you know, we go here. So this is me through my capture card. So let's say it's me fighting somebody, then I'm good right here. You know. Actually, let me just play on my arcade stick, because I've been playing on my arcade stick. I haven't touched controller for this game. Shiro Mikoto, style. Hard. Mikoto, style. Good choice. So when we play online tournaments, we always go to the training stage, because it's just this big training stage, no lag, no issues. So, you know, this is basically how we're gonna, you know, we do our tournaments. That we have the characters here, we have the scoreboard, I keep score and everything. This is PlayStation, right? So let's say, oh, Shinji, you're showing me your point of view. How you do it so that people on PlayStation, how you do your spectate? So I'm like, all right, this is how we do spectate. So we go over here where it says game base, if you're on PS5. I think it's like party chat or whatever on PS4. But you go over here, right? You go to game base. So then you go where it says start a party. So you hit start a party. You want to do close party, right? So you do close party. So then you go here and you invite... Hey, what's up, Hard Knocks? So then you go here and you invite the people that you want, or you can hit create new group, and then you search your friends here, and you pick who you want. Make sure that those people are in your friends list when you're doing tournaments for Phantom Breaker or any tournament that doesn't have like a spectate mode. I mean, yeah, that doesn't have a spectate mode. So you go over here, blah, 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 blah. You know, Jubailey, Google my name. So, you know, you just do that. And then you start the party, and then, you know, you hit share screen. I'm going to start a party. I'm going to close in a second. But you start a party. And then you see here, I share screen, right? So then if you're in the party, like in there, you can see and you can view it, right? So now I hit this. So when your indicator, comes in, then I can view. You can start it, and you can start a share screen. I can view you. You get what I'm saying? Now, share play is different. Share play is like you come in and we play the game. Like we can share the game and stuff like that. But share screen, there is a share screen. I think only PS5 can do that, if I'm not mistaken. I think the PS5 can do that. Maybe the PS4. Maybe yeah, they added it in PS4. Not sure because I haven't seen it. But yeah. You come over here and you share your screen. So that's how we get spectate. Like I said before, Discord, same thing. So like we see here's the tile. This is how it's gonna be, the tournament and all that. When you watch tournaments, you know, we have the logo here, the scoreboards and stuff like that. So Let me get back to this. This is going to be the commentary stuff. Again, I'm going to put my webcam on probably in the next couple of days. Just have the picture of me. Maybe my Street Fighter hat. But anyway, so yeah, so I do a lot for the Phantom Breaker community. Even Nintendo Switch. So here's the thing with Nintendo Switch. Nintendo Switch lacks in a lot of things, right? It's hard to spectate on that game, unless you're a streamer, unless you have a capture card, then that's the only source of, that's the only way we can spectate, is if you have a capture card. We can try to like have you hold the record button on the Switch, and hopefully you can get your whole match in, like the first round and the second round, and you know, do it by clips like that. That's another method, and that's probably what I'm going to try to do for the Switch tournament that's coming soon. I'll post the dates and announcements for that. Maybe tomorrow I'll have it up. But yeah, Nintendo Switch is the hardest version to host tournaments in. But I make it happen because there's a lot of people that play this game on the Switch or own it on the Switch. And I'm the type of person that I don't want to leave anyone out. And I know they're like, oh, hey, Shinji, but what about the Xbox? We've done Xbox tournaments. We've done two Xbox tournaments. Now, the North American scene for this game on Xbox is very strange. Very strange. I actually was going to do a tournament for it, like, what, 2 months ago? And it was looking good. Then people decided to like quit, and then someone donated $40 to the tournament and dipped. He dipped. And I was like, okay. So I didn't touch the money. I left the money there for like a month. And after that, they're like, yeah, no, keep it. That's donation. And I was like, all right. So I started using it for other games that I host, you know, Street Fighter 6, then Fire Herds, Melty Blood. So I split it to those, and that's what I did with that. But I want to do stuff for the Xbox community because, you know, I don't want them thinking that I hate on Xbox. No, I enjoy Xbox. It's just now Xbox is looking like the go-to for a lot of games now, because Sony, at the time, Sony was exclusive to fighting games with some of the stuff that was going on. But now Sony's is being weird with some of their pricing, that now people are like kind of jumping ship and going to Xbox because, you know, you got Game Pass and PlayStation Plus or whatever exclusives doesn't give you a good variety. And Game Pass, you can get day one games if they have it on Game Pass. Boom, it's there. And what, Game Pass is like, what, $60 for the whole year? That's worth it. You got what I'm saying? You're getting $60, $70 games basically for free. I know it's digital download, but hey, you get to play them. You don't have to spend money. You know, you just got to pay for the whole year for Game Pass, and I guess you got to pay for your yearly subscription. I don't know if one pays for all. I'm not sure. I don't own the Xbox. If you can help me out, Hard Knocks, you own Xbox. Do you for Game Pass? That's separate from the online, right? The online bundle. Because you have Xbox Live, that's for online, and then Game Pass is another subscription. So you're basically paying for two subscriptions, right? Game Pass doesn't incorporate the online. Oh, Xbox Live is merging into Game Pass now, so is it going to be like a totally different price, or? Well, whatever the price is, it's affordable. It's affordable. Whatever the price is, I mean, if that merger is like $100, I think it's worth it. For the whole year? No more Xbox Live Gold. Gotcha. So if that Game Pass core is like $100, I really think it's worth it. For the whole year, it's worth it. So yeah, there's, like I said, there's other TOs or other community hosts, like KRX. He's the owner of the global server, and he does his, his events. His are all more I want to say like different from what I do. I'm more traditional tournament. There's times that I do like, oh, you gotta play this character or random select. And KRX, he does Fenebreaker. He does Fenebreaker Fridays. He goes into rank, and there's signs that he does lobbies with friends. Like, he does lobbies with me. But like, when he does his tournament, when he hosts some tournaments, they're different. It's a different rule settings. Like, he had one called the Big, the Bad, and the Ugly. And I think you like one person played like a hero, the other person can play like a villain. I forgot the other one, the other stuff. Then we had like random select. We had a, I think it was it a random select tournament? I don't know if it was a random select tournament, but yeah, he does a lot of unique stuff. And then, I incorporate some stuff as well. But again, I keep mine at time like mostly just straight up traditional tournaments. And it's good to have different like types of tournaments, 'cause it helps out the community, like different vibes. Like, for instance, like I'm gonna do it in Japan for Japan, because I know Japan will do it with me. I'll see if I'll do it with America. But it's Volfine's idea. Volfine was the one that told well, made a post about it, but I'm not sure when he's gonna do it, so I'm probably gonna step in. But I'm gonna talk to him. But he wants to do like a secondary character tournament. So basically, we play the secondaries. We can't play our mains. We play the secondaries. But if I was gonna implement my way, I was gonna put character bans. So, for instance, like me, if I'm gonna enter a secondary tournament, I can't play Yuzuha. I can't play Tokia. I can't play Maestra. I can't play Makoto. And I can't play Remy, because they're not really my secondaries. I play them, they're like my mains. Right, so I can't play those characters, but I can play anyone else that's not in that ban list. So if I was to be like like Japan, like Volfine, his main is Mei, and his secondary but really main Ende. So I'll be like, yo, you can't play Ende, you can't play Mei. Who else? You can't play Shiro Makoto. You can't play Isuke, because he's actually good with those characters as well. We'll keep it like a two character ban, because I'm gonna be like, oh, you can't play anybody. But yeah, so something like that in that nature. If I was to host it, I would put bans. Like, you can't use your main. Yeah, he plays L. Yeah, he's been playing L since I've met him. But he hasn't like committed to hasn't fully committed to the character like he is now. We played for a while today, but I wanna do like an hour and a half. It was just me and him going at it while the other guys were playing IO Showdown and Guilty Gear Strive. Me and Volfin were playing freaking Phantom Breaker. But yeah, that's what I want to do. There is a Nintendo Switch tournament coming. I'll post the dates probably tomorrow for it. I do need to write Rocket Panda games. I'll probably write Rocket Panda games tonight with all the information for the NA tournament. That way we can get some prizes going. And if they send me stuff, then I'll send some stuff to the winners, on my behalf. On my behalf, like Final Wave Esports and stuff like that. Not sure if I'm gonna ask them for Phantom Breaker medals, because I'm pretty sure we all have medals. Well, not for like MCM and myself. I have freaking Phantom Breaker medals. But you know what? I'll ask them for medals. That way, I can send them out to the NA peeps, and I'll hold some on the side when I go to, because I really do want to go to EVO Japan, next year. So I'm definitely saving up for that. I'm gonna do a lot of streaming. Hopefully, I can raise some money on stream, or if I get subs to the channel, that can help me out to go to EVO Japan. That's like one of my super main goals, is to go to EVO Japan for next year. And yeah, to play Phantom Breaker, but not just that, but I want to see my second family, which is the Japan community. I want to see them. Also, go sightseeing and stuff like that. But I want to go see my homies, you know? And of course, I'm gonna get some stuff. I'll get some gifts. But you guys gotta give me the money to get it for you guys. I'm not gonna go and use my money. Maybe on some stuff. Maybe for certain people, I'll get some stuff. But yeah, yeah, I gotta write Rocket Panda. But anyway, future plans for Phantom Breaker Omnia for the fall season and the winter season. So after Phantom Breaker Festival, the month of October, we're kind of gonna take like a little break. I'm still gonna play the game. I'm talking about like content wise. There's gonna be like a maybe I'll do like a let's like Phantom Breaker Fridays, but that's KRX's thing. But I'll do like maybe a Phantom Breaker day, for October, maybe bi-weekly or something. But like I said, I want to cool it down, because again, Phantom Breaker Festival is from now until the end of the month. You get what I'm saying? So this is just day one. Tomorrow we're gonna play some more Battlegrounds with a different character. We're gonna have some Phantom Breaker Omnia in the morning with Japan, maybe in the afternoon if I talk to other people that are interested. I still need to get people for exhibitions, stuff like that. So there's a lot of stuff going, a lot of stuff's happening on the fly too, because there's some stuff that I had planned, but then I was like, oh shit, exhibitions. I totally forgot to get people for the exhibition, so that's going to be on the fly. So whoever I can get, I can get. Will I play in any of the exhibitions? To be honest, I do, but again, this is not about me. This is not about me. I may be the one that's doing a lot for the community, but this is not for me. This is I did this. This sparked up my idea of Phantom Breaker Festival for you guys, and me being salty because this game wasn't at CEO Otaku, but we'll talk about that another time. But anyway, no, I'm just kidding. But no, again, I did this for you guys, for you Phantom Breaker players, fans, new, old, I. I did this for you guys, you know, because I care about this game. I care about you guys, even though I can be very hard-headed and strict. This is how I am. I don't know what else to say about that. But I do care about everybody, and I make sure that we have a good community. You know, it does annoy me sometimes when people come in like, oh, this game doesn't have rollback, oh, this game doesn't have combo trials, oh, this game doesn't have spectators. I get it. And I agree with you. You know, I freaking complain, yo. Oh, can we get spectate? Like, I'm gonna be 100% with you guys. I don't care if we have rollback. All I want is a spectators mode, and the reason why I want a spectators mode is because of the Nintendo Switch. That's why I want a spectators mode. The Switch, as I mentioned earlier, is the hardest one out of the three to do anything. To host tournaments for it. I mean, I can stream content, it's just my POV, my perspective. You get what I'm saying? And hopefully someone else has a capture card that I can look at. But yeah, the Nintendo Switch is the hardest one to do anything, but I'm here doing my best, and we're going to have a Switch tournament. Now here's the thing with the Switch tournament, right? It's going to be hard. I know it's going to be hard. I'm up for the challenge, you know, but I'm not going to give up on these guys, on the Switch community. It's gonna be a different. I'm telling you as of right now, the Switch tournament is gonna be the most difficult. I'm gonna have a headache when the tournament starts, because I know for a fact it's gonna be. I'm not saying like in the mean way or anything, but it's probably gonna be like maybe one or two people are gonna forget to save, to like save some sort of clip of their matches. It doesn't have to be the whole match, but just a clip. And then another thing too is, I know for a fact there's going to be a few people that don't have a Twitter. So I'm not sure how the hell they're going to upload those clips for me to watch and kind of compile them into a tournament. But again, it's going to happen. We're going to do it. I'm going to bitch about it because that's usually what I do. Not in a bad way, just. You know, it's just I need spectate. So hope, but here's another thing too, right? And I'm gonna say this before I go. Oh, before anything. All right, guys, if you scroll up, you see where it says Stream Elements? This says Download Stormshot Skull Island Odyssey. Guys, it'll mean the world to me. Yo, you even have to like. I mean, it's really easy to get the 2.5 mil power. That's the second stage. But yo, getting to level 5 is like so quick in that game. And it's funny too, especially how you kill people when you do a little those little puzzles. But yo, if y'all can download that game on your phone, you have to click on the link, download it from the QR code, play that game. Just get to Stronghold 5 for me. I appreciate it. Just get to that. Play on your phone. We gotta click on that link. I click on that link. I'll type it in again before I get to what I need to say. All right, help me out, 'cause if we get the first goal done, I can use that and further for and it'll help with the Phantom Breaker, Hamiya, really. Like I do all the. Everybody thinks like, yo, why are you playing these mobile games or whatever? They look whack. Hey, they may look whack, but that whackness is what helps pay for some of these tournaments that I do for you guys. So take that into consideration, because I remember when someone laughed at me that I was a sellout for Raid Shadow Legends, but those guys paid me like almost 800 just to play Raid Shadow Legends. That helped me out a lot. That helped me get a lot of my PC stuff. I still need to get more, but that's another story. But anyway, I took that raid money. I did, man. That Raid Shadow Legends. I'm about to hit them up. I'm about to hit them up. I'm about to hit them up again. I'm gonna write them an email. Be like, hey, y'all sponsor me. I'll play your game. You scratch my back, I scratch yours, and if they agree on that, yo, that'll be amazing. Cause I can use that Raid Shadow Legends funds again. For me, but also for you guys as well. Yeah, I had like a small sponsorship with them. It was like 7 days. I had to play their game, and the first goal, I had to get like 30 people, which I did. It was easy. And that was 300. And then they came on my stream, like this stream that we're seeing now. They came on my stream and they liked my flow, and they just dropped 400 bucks on top of the 300. And then they extended my goal. They gave me a second stage goal. That gave me more money. And I was like, oh yeah, freaking mad, yo, mad people did it. And then you can still do it too. Just don't talk bad about them. That's it. Cause they got on a couple of people. They got a couple of people, but I think they still do sponsorships. But anyway, enough about Raid Shadow Legends. Let me get back to this topic. So, winter 2023 Phantom Breaker is going to be the Phantom Breaker Awards. I was going to do the Phantom Breaker Awards for Phantom Breaker Festival, but it's a little early. It's a little early. But what I'll do is for the winter season, and this will be in December, I'll have to pick a day for the Phantom Breaker Awards. I gotta pick a day that NA and Japan can see it at the same time. Unless I have to do two different streams. I have to do an award ceremony for NA and a award ceremony for Japan. Now, this is just me thinking, right? This is just thoughts. It's not finalized yet. But if I can get my hands on it, I can get some. I'm going to try to get like an award, like a plaque type deal for some people. I'm not going to say what the awards are, but I'll say one. Like, funniest moments or something, like something funny that happened in Japan, or something funny that happened. Sorry about that. Yeah, so we'll see what's up with that, but it's going to be like an award ceremony. It's going to be like maybe 40 minutes. It's not going to be a long thing. I'll probably, for the people that won, I'll probably have them, if they want to, be on the stream, say a little thing. I'll cut you off. I'll play the opera music. You know, like the Dave Chappelle skit. You know, cut it out. Cut it out, bro. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, so we'll do an award ceremony, because I wanted to do an award ceremony for Phantom Breaker Festival, but I feel like it's too early. So it's going to be like the end of the year, type of deal. It's not going to be a long stream. It's going to be 40 minutes tops, and it's another celebration, of what we accomplished this whole year. Hopefully, I can get some highlights or something. Even though I was supposed to do highlights for Thronebreaker Festival, but I'll put the highlights for this award ceremony. And that's it for the winter season. And for 2024, I do not know what plans we have. I know that we're still going to be playing Thronebreaker, but as for events and stuff like that, we have to wait and see. I know I'm gonna be 100%. I know we have to work our asses off for this game for next year. Like, straight up. We're gonna work. We have to work hard. If you play this game and you support it and you do what you gotta do, it's not just me. You get what I'm saying? That's going out there and speaking for this game. The players need to step up as well. It can't just be me, like, oh hey, I need spectate mode. And then people at Rocket Panda headquarters be like, oh yeah, there goes Shinji again asking for spectate mode. If they just see it's me, they're not gonna care. But if there's other people that speak up, the more people that speak up and ask, then it'll be like, oh shit. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Like, for this game, I don't know what the future is for this game. For NA, that is. I know Japan's still gonna be on this game. Japan's still on this game. As for North America, this game is oh my God, I don't even want to say it. I didn't want to say it. But yeah. Anyway, with that, I bid you guys a farewell. I appreciate everyone that took the time to stop by and watch the stream, watch Thronebreaker Battlegrounds Overdrive, me playing Infinity. That was kind of funny. I think tomorrow we're gonna do some Japanese lobbies. Then we're gonna play Nagi with Battlegrounds, and then maybe play with the NA community if I can find. I gotta hit some people up. Some Thronebreaker Omnia, probably on PS4, maybe some Steam, maybe Switch. But yeah, I appreciate you guys. Again, if you missed out on the whole stream, I will have this up on YouTube. But yeah, this is it for Thronebreaker Festival Day 1. Thank you guys for stopping by. Appreciate you guys. You have a good Wednesday night. I'll probably be back later with a different game. But yeah. Take it easy. Be good to yourself. Be good to your communities, whether it's Thronebreaker or not. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. This is Shinji from Final Wave Esports signing off.